Elf Guardian Regiment always accompany you on your walks?
Always. Papa's orders. It's for your protection, Rosa dear. People here hate us. Why? What have I done to them? But enough about that. Soldier, you may leave.
But His Excellency Ambassador Bar Atra said that...
And this Excellency is telling you otherwise. Do you not recognize him? This is Geralt of Rivia, the best swordsman the North has ever seen. I'm safe with him. Now march off, quickly. Left, right, left, right. Finally. Let's go, Geralt. I've something I wish to show you.
We were supposed to train, not go for a walk.
I know, Geralt. Now stop harping on about it and let's go.
Beg anyone for her life. Then the flames flared up, licking the rooftops. She hadn't the time to scream.
Here. You see, I thought that instead of training in a dank old cellar, we'd move around in the open air. A duel on a bridge, like in the novels. Now draw your sword.
Only got my steel and silver swords. We should be fighting with practice weapons.
We should, but you of all people ought to know, there's much more fun in doing things you shouldn't.
Listen, I'd really rather not hurt you.
Stop patronizing me, or you'll be the one to get hurt. Now on guard.
You're quick!
What are you doing?
Are you sure? Oh, I parried too late.
You all right?
Yes. The only thing you've really hurt is my pride.
Are you sure? Because you were bleeding a lot. Oh my god.
All right. What's next?
We should return.
Jesus.
Forgive me, Geralt. I know this might sound awkward. But would you mind turning around for a moment? My corset's shifted. It's pinching me terribly.
Yankee, what's up? Thanks for the 11 months.
I understand a woman wanting to look pretty, but fighting in a corset, it slows you. Rosa? Shit, she ran off. Anything happens to her, Varatra will kill me. Need to find her.
You will try.
Can't be far.
Trouble?
Far from home, aren't you, sweetie? And there's no telling if you'll ever get back.
She's Ambassador Varatra's daughter. She's got diplomatic immunity.
I don't really understand the shite you're saying. Now it's clear you love your black ones.
It's no surprise, Lucas. Witches are drawn to monsters, just the way things are. But this beastie, we'll tempt it with her ourselves.
I believe you've offended the young lady. Now apologize, as nicely as you can.
Forgive me, milady. I am sorry.
Your turn. Be nice like your friend. Bow low, and go be a patriot somewhere else.
Lucas and Cobe. I shall remember those names. And when the Emperor takes Novigrad, I will find them and have them pay.
Easy. Didn't hurt you in the end.
They raised their hand against me. That's enough to have that hand lopped off.
And you wonder why the locals hate Nilfgaard.
I thought you were different from other Nordlings. That you understand us, our sense of justice. I see I was wrong.
You should go home now. And take the shortest, not the scenic route.
I understand. Farewell, Geralt. And good luck on the path.
That's not justice. That's like retribution or something. That's like... Justice would be, I mean, if they had like attacked her, maybe, but they literally didn't even touch you. If they had actually attacked her, then I could see maybe that being a fair punishment, but... Snacks you get?
Devil's spawn.
Pita chips.
Pete.
Is it wrong for you
the
to be missed?
The last individual who tried to come in on my business, it took them a month to find him. Am I being clear, Chive?
What's the fuss about? Can you not treat me as a bit of healthy competition?
Why are you even talking to him, Duke? I've always maintained two smashed knees are worth a thousand words.
Oh, Geralt! Glad you came.
There a problem?
A problem? There's some kind of problem here, gents. Oh, just wanted you to meet my new pals before they bugger the fuck off. Because we're just parting, right?
We'll have our reckoning yet, Chive. Soon.
What's this? Some flea-ridden mutant got you scared, Duke? Just say the word. I'll take care of him. Take a peek at what he's got inside, then make the midget eat it. Sound good?
Next time, Earl. Let's go.
Right. Don't show your hides around here ever again. Well, that puts me up to the neck in fucking shite without the shovel.
Yeah, what's going on here?
What's this all about? Doing business with them?
Exactly, they're plowing opposite. You see, Geralt, old pal...
About to ask me for help, aren't you?
The thing is, I sort of kind of owe a wee sum to a mutual acquaintance. Francis
Oh,
Bedlam,
I was just on my way there. Nice.
The King of Beggars. To pay off the debt, I've made up my mind to get serious about Gwent.
Getting better by the minute.
Not the playing of it, mind you, but the cards themselves. Rarest of them fetch princely sums these days. Sadly, that's not exactly arcane knowledge. Got a buyer in heat for my collection, missing just three cards. But Duke's dregs are all over my arse, so... What do you say, Geralt?
Fine. We'll try to hunt down those cards. Which ones you need?
Fringilla, Vigo, Isengrim, and John Natalis. Devilish hard to get hold of. Duke's been trying too, hasn't had any luck.
Wait, you don't even know where to look for these cards?
Nah, it's not as bad as that. I'm betting Zed's got them. He quit fencing recently, only deals in cards now. Unfortunately, the arsewhite won't talk to me. Not after I bought a one-of-a-kind Scoia'tael card out from under his nose. Boy, would you mind going to see him?
Zed. Sounds familiar.
Big fish in the card pond. There's a shop along the south wall. And thank you, Geralt. I actually think I stand to pay off this debt now.
No problem. See you later, Zoltan.
Right carriage last night. Head feels like it's full of sauerkraut.
Is this truly what
What's the hurry?
To be purveying cheap whores and watered down wine?
Hey, I can't control what I inherit.
But you can control what you do with it.
I know, which is exactly why I'm considering.
Oh,
looking
you're
for
always considering.
Something unusual?
If it's not one thing, it's another. Let me know when you finally decide.
Damn. Baroness, what's up? Thanks for the 26-month resub. Have some amber. Thanks so much for the over 2 years of support.
She spat in my face. Or might as well have. Called me a whoremonger and a witless hack. Can you imagine? Wit is my forte.
Gotta say, Priscilla's really growing on me.
Save it.
And why don't you save your pouting? Prove to her she's wrong.
Exactly what I plan to do. I've always dreamed of having my own cabaret. A bit of paint and plaster, and this place will do splendidly. Just one hitch. I need coin. So, if you happen to get a break between drowners and ekamajigs, maybe you can help an old friend out.
Maybe the Vivaldis would give you a loan. I'd vouch for you.
Funny you mention that. I went to see Vivaldi. Know what he said? Witchers are no good as guarantors. Risk of premature death is way too high. But I have another idea. I dated this girl once, Sophronia. That's a name if you can believe it. Has a merchant for a father, importer of spices from Zeracania. And Daddy Dear would never refuse his daughter Dear a thing. We can borrow the coin from her.
Name rings a bell. Isn't this the woman you abandoned without saying a word? Stepped out for a bottle of wine, never to return?
You know, I bought that wine for a reason.
Long time ago, that.
Been away a while, sure. Which is why I need to draw on your authority. You've got some, you know. No matter what you might think.
Fine. Tell me what you want. Got a feeling you've a plan all cooked up.
Sophronia could still be holding a grudge after our unfortunate parting. But with a touch of help from you, I know she'll forgive me. And then give me that loan.
What's this help entail?
First of all, we need to borrow a dull sword from Madame Irina. One of her props. You know, the kind they use during performances? Get that, then meet me outside Sophronia's house.
Let's say I agree and go see Madame Irina. What'll you be doing in the meantime?
Something I have to finish. But I promise I'll do it before you come back with the sword. Then I'll tell you the rest.
Fine, but...
Geralt, the only butts in this plan will be the ones filling my seats. It'll work, you'll see. Get the sword from Madame Irina and meet me outside Sophronia's at sunset.
Old man Newman left me a gift last time.
Alright.
He never given me
Priscilla, you're blocking the door.
I have strength, Geralt. Perhaps you can talk some sense into it.
I would love to leave, if you don't mind. And character. Priscilla, you're blocking the door. Priscilla! God, is there another exit? Jesus.
What's he schemed up this time?
Snake eyes. Oh, hey.
Hey, you like a dog.
Stop walking into the soul! He's
that stench.
That's rude of you. Okay, well, my GPS told me to go this direction. Stupid GPS. Liars. Liars. How do I get around this stupid building?
Open up.
Open up. I've been here before.
Oi,
fuck up.
So he saw God.
Oi.
Should pick your men more carefully. Rico blew his cover like a novice.
Yeah, he told me. And I told him to leave town. Most likely promised I'd reward you, didn't he?
So he said.
Take it.
This poor prick. I joined into a con.
Mm-hmm.
I want to leave this sword. And a terrible version of it with Easter.
Aura Darts, what's up? Thank you for the 6 month resub. Have some hamburgers. Thank you so much for your continued support. Congrats on the upgraded burger. Thank you. Do I have to go up? Yeah, we gotta go up.
Wind's howling.
Is it? Hello.
Ah, so good to see you.
Got a request. Need to borrow one of your props. One of the swords you use for stage battles.
My. Whatever do you need that for?
I don't know, but Dandelion claims it's essential.
Oh, yes. I suspected Master Dandelion might have a hand in this. I certainly hope you don't aim to compete with me. Voila.
Thanks. I'll try not to damage it. So long.
Just look at the freak.
Don't know who you're looking for, but you won't find
it. Did you see those poor wretches?
Wait, how do I... Is there a way to go through the other side? Yeah.
Hey!
I'm not even doing anything. God, stop overreacting.
Scandalous.
Jeez.
Proven takes a cut. Cleaver takes a cut. How's a man to turn up?
After dusk. Well, it's 6:30.
Nothing.
Maybe if we just wait. What's happening? Okay.
Finally made it. Listen, here's the plan. Sophronia loves adventure-filled romance novels. I can be a hero in her eyes if I can just save her from a bandit. I'll have her eating out of my hand, and there's no way she'll begrudge me that loan.
Want me to be the bandit?
Knew you'd see the sense in it right away.
Are you serious? That's your brilliant plan?
I never called it brilliant, but any kind of plan is better than none. Written your lines already.
You've written what?
So you know what to say during the performance. Here, Andromask, put it on. Sophronia can't recognize you.
But...
No time. Sophronia's coming. Stick to the plan. We'll meet at the Rosemary in the morning.
Poor Geralt. He's like, what?
Stop right there.
What is this? Help! Save me!
Tremble, flaxen-haired wench. Bow before the Prince of Thieves.
Not so fast. Drop your sword, scoundrel. This is your first and last warning.
Dandelion!
Tis I,
Geralt in the background.
Though the scum of the city call me the Crimson Avenger.
Crimson Avenger.
No, not the Crimson Avenger.
Geralt.
Silence, vermin! You shall regret the day you were born.
Not the Crimson Avenger.
You're better than I thought.
Am I supposed to, like, actually fight him? I don't know.
Dandelion!
Avenger!
I don't... Am I
the
supposed
Crimson
to?
Avenger.
Oh, there you go. Okay. I was like, I don't know.
Are you well?
One blow struck true. Another scar from my collection.
Come inside. I shall bandage you up. Be gone, vile bandit, or the Crimson Avenger will beat you senseless! Those hunters would burn a rainbow if they could.
No two ways about it.
She was talking about the witch hunters that were like burning people at the stake. She said those hunters would burn a rainbow if they could.
Power of the eternal fire.
It's funny.
Double chase.
All right. Gotta wait here till morning.
Old man Newman left me a gift last time.
There's been a misunderstanding. You're here too early.
What? We agreed to meet today, so we've come today. Supplies are all hauled in and the crew's raring to work. We'll start just as soon as our lovely directress gets round to deciding on the decoration.
But Dandelion doesn't even have the coin to pay you.
Turns out he does now, or soon will. At any rate, he's working on it.
See? It's all peachy. So will you finally decide what style you want for this interior?
What are our choices?
Master Dandelion said he was torn between boudoir style and theater decor. Promised to let us know his choice as soon as we arrived. Now we're here, but no decision's been made. And the lady's horribly surprised she's to choose. Though apparently this whole renovation's for her sake.
For me?
Well, it's not for me. Now, would you please decide where I'd bust a vessel?
I've no idea what Dandelion would like. Geralt, you've known him longer. Say something.
Sure, I've known him longer, but he's never so much as changed his socks for me. Never mind commissioning a full-blown renovation. He's doing this for you, clearly. You should decide.
I associate boudoirs with a feminine elegance that also has an edge. Claws, you might say. That fits a cabaret perfectly.
A wonderful choice it is. At last. Gentlemen, you're done lollygagging. Get to work.
Well, well. Guess this cabaret's the real thing.
Ever since Dandelion inherited this place, he's talked about it constantly. I just never expected him to take action. And so quickly.
Who knows? Might even settle down now. He'll have to keep an eye on the business. Who would have known?
Despite what people say about him, Dandelion approaches life very rationally.
We talking about the same Dandelion? Man who loses a fortune worth half of Novigrad in one night.
Dandelion can also be responsible. He always pays anyone who works for a long time, and he's never missed a performance.
Sure hope your opening won't be the first. He's still not here.
Well, he said as soon as he got the coin, he'd go see Polly, our choreographer. She's missed the last few rehearsals. I certainly hope he's not gotten into trouble.
Anything's possible with Dandelion. Let me see if I can't find him.
Yeah, handsome.
Okay. Gay old nightclub.
Nothing doing. Some.
Knowing Dandelion, he has gotten himself into trouble.
Oh, terrible times.
Kiss a copper.
What's the ruckus about?
Polly and her half-brained fiancé. They're fighting. She's the only one in this town who knows anything about choreography, and that lummox won't let her work for me.
Because...
Hold on. What are you doing here? We were gonna meet at the Rosemary.
We were, but you didn't show. Priscilla started to worry, so I came to see how you were doing.
Priscilla started worrying about me? That's so nice!
Great.
Less for her than for you, I'm sure. So let's get back.
Did you not hear what's going on in there? We've gotta help Polly. Why do beautiful women always end up with such dicks?
No idea. Stand back. I'll break the door down.
Wait! Do we have to destroy her house? She keeps a spare key around here somewhere.
Fine. Let's find the key. Not here.
Damn. What? Now where would she leave?
Not here.
We could just like go in through the window that's completely open.
The key.
What's up, Lauren? What's up?
Whoa! What the devil's it? Get out of my ass!
Watch it, and leave the woman alone.
What the... She's my betrothed!
But I'm not your property!
I love her! I'll not let her sway her ass in his brothel!
Whoa! Slow down there a minute. This is clearly one gigantic misunderstanding. One I can clear up in the blink of an eye.
Shove your excuses up your ass! Sod off, or I'll split your skull!
My friend asked you nicely, so please be courteous in return and hear him out, or we'll settle this another way.
Alright, talk.
Hubio, right? Polly's told me so much about you. She said you're erudite and have an open mind.
You said that? Well, there's a truth to it. My mind's the open salt. But its open-saltedness ends when my betrothed starts wagging her ass around brothels. Get out of here, both of yous. Polly's not going anywhere.
Let him finish. There's no brothel involved.
You see, friend, Geralt just hit the nail on the head. For what you have there is the old publicity placard.
Old?
Very. From a time when my establishment was under different management. I, however, would never let any indecency take place in my cabaret. My very reputation precludes it.
So, what's all this about?
Your betrothed is a first-class artiste, and I want to offer her a position worthy of her talents. She's to be my choreographer, and that in turn means she'll receive a share of the proceeds from every performance she choreographs.
You mean to say... coin?
And fame. No flirting required. You have my word.
Suppose... in that case...
I knew you'd agree.
It's settled then. See you at the Rosemary, Polly.
Oh. I like that. That's cute.
Well, I'm off.
It's like...
I'll catch up to you.
She'll be our choreographer, and she will earn money for choreographing all of our shows. She'll earn a split of the revenue. You mean to say, coin?
You handled it well, Dandelion. Man was putty in your hands once you called him erudite.
In negotiation, as in combat, the key is to find your opponent's weak spot and exploit it to the hilt.
So, time to head back?
I've still got to stop by Rotlicks. Commissioned some new placards from him a while ago, but Hubio came across the old version. Plowing artists got some serious explaining to do.
I'll go see Rotlick. You head back to the Rosemary. Priscilla will have my head.
Really? You'd go?
Sure.
No, said that for the hell of it. Tell me where he lives.
Geralt, Jesus, dude.
Portside.
See you soon.
Freakish, what's up, dude? Thanks for the 24 months. Tell me where he lives. Portside. That's not an address. What? This entire city is ports. Yeah, I'm gonna play the DLCs.
Oh, it's pissed.
Show. He lives in Novigrad.
Ow.
Somewhere. I guess when there's only a few... Do you guys just hear a ghost or... It's like the people on the boat. Okay, that makes more sense. It's them, like, yelling out what- okay, cool. That makes sense. I totally lost track of what I was saying.
Sail to Skirriga, at your age. Now, the war on.
What's going on?
A Witcher? Oh, hear about the notice by chance?
Not quite, but what's it about? I hear right you're going on some voyage, need a companion.
Not just some voyage, cross the sea. Mark this, when I got pressed into the infantry in 1242, I promised my beloved letter I'd return alive, whole, and with a pearl from Skellige. Not just any pearl either, a black one, the rarest and most precious.
Well, well, ambitious.
Perhaps, but they were empty words. I came from the war, that one and the next, but I never fulfilled my promise. High time to change that. Or if not now, then when? Thing is, I've grown old in the meantime, as you see. Can't manage it alone, need a strong shoulder to lean on. Witcher's shoulders as strong as they come. So, what do you say?
Sure.
Plan's crazier than it is sane, but there's an irresistible charm to it. Offer me some pay and I'll help you out.
Don't you fret about coin. I brought home a good deal of it from various fronts. Say we meet in Skellige, by the collapsed bridge near Arinbjorn. It's but a hop away from the bed where black pearls are born. Will that work for you?
Sounds fine. See you there.
Great. Oh. Awkward. You walk in, it just says Bandit.
Looking for Rodlick.
You ain't alone. Damn halfling's in debt to half the city. But I'm here to scrape mine before the carcass is picked clean.
There's not enough for everyone, so bugger off. Feeding time's first come, first served.
Take what you want. I'm just here for some placards.
You diff. Didn't you hear me? This is all mine now. Fuck off, freak!
And here I thought we'd resolve this peacefully.
I can't use my sword or fire? What?
Not good.
Oh my god.
Shit.
Why does Geralt keep turning his back? What are you doing, dude? Okay. This is so dumb. Like, why can't I just pull my sword out and... Why can't... Dude, parry, you shit! I can't heal, and I can't use my swords, and I can't use my signs.
How much Rodlick owes you, but everything in this house is mine. Wanna get something back? Try the Vagelbud estate. Rodlick's losing his last crowns at the races, I wager.
I don't care about this. No. Seriously? And then we can't redo it? Are you joking? Why do we have to fist fight bandits inside of a house? That's the dumbest shit I've ever seen. We have to fist fight them? Why would we fist fight bandits? That's so stupid. And this is 4 minutes ago. No, I don't think you're supposed to. Are you supposed to lose? I feel like I've won before. I just, like, was too busy trying to use potions and shit to, like, actually do anything. I don't want to reload like 4 minutes ago. I don't know what this is. It works whether you lose or win. What do you mean it works? What works? I don't think it's worth it to reload because it's going to take 1,000 years to reload.
Get off.
So we have to go all the way out there. That's just really dumb. I hate when they're like, you have to fist fight these dumbass bandits, and you can't use your potions or drink water or anything. Like, you literally, you can't do anything than you would normally do when fighting bandits. Why is this any different? No. No, thank you. Well, that's stupid. I don't agree with that in the first second. Okay. Well, because now we have to go, like, all the way out to the Vagal Buds, which is out here. What time is it? Big morning? I'm just very annoyed that this is a stupid thing that we have to do. If they would, I don't know, if it's like a forced lose, okay, but don't make it like that. That's a shitty feeling. Yeah, just some like random crappy bandits. Like, you're nothing. Why do I have to fist fight you and then lose a fist fight?
Seems you're a considerable.
You Rodlick.
Henri Rortlick, artist, painter, debtor, and martyr to my art. At your service.
Dandelion sent me.
Oh, yes. Tell him his placards are done and safely hidden away. Yet,
it's
alas,
not about
I
whether or not you can
them.
Beat them. I'm not... I don't care if you can beat them. That's not the point.
Think I might have run into one of them.
Then you know my predicament. Now, Count de Louverton has offered me the chance to win it all back. I'm to wager on a race.
What's there to worry about? This is your chance to settle up, get a clean slate.
I've had a spell of bad luck lately. Should I agree to de Louverton's offer and lose, I shall be in bondage to him for all time.
Let me pay off your debt. No strings attached.
Thank you. I never expected this.
You're a witcher, you can't just cut down anybody you want.
Generosity.
Bandits?
Let's just say I like to.
I can't cut down bandits? What are you talking about? They're bandits. They're attacking me.
I'll bring them to the Rosemary in time. Just as soon as I settle my obligations.
They're not just random people. They're not just random people standing in the street. They're bandits and they're attacking me. What are you saying? What? That doesn't make any sense. Yeah, that doesn't make any sense. They're literally criminals, and they're like in the way, they're in the process of attacking me. Why wouldn't I be able to kill them? Yeah, they were also in the middle of committing a crime. We've killed people for way less than that. Jesus.
Oh, it's hard to like a pirate.
Wow!
Grand opening tonight!
We start NG.
Right. Well, well. See, the crew's been hard at work. Not bad.
No. No, not all. But I'd imagine something more, you know, more theatrical.
Don't you like it? But I thought a boudoir would be right in line with your tastes.
Oh, you chose it. Well, I'm not saying it's bad. Just different. Not exactly what I'd envisaged.
Why are they so shiny?
You know, now that I think about it, you're absolutely right. A boudoir is the perfect setting for a cabaret. What about Rotlick? Did you get the placards?
Rotlick said he'd bring them on his own. Should be here soon.
Great! The best way I can think of to promote the chameleon.
Never mentioned wanting to change the name.
Rosemary and Thyme wasn't all bad, but it conjured images of Temerian cuisine served by waitresses in peasant garb. Chameleon's a lot better for a cabaret, apart from which it emphasizes that the place has undergone a transformation.
Yeah.
Just a better ring to it all round.
Guess everything's ready. So when's the opening?
Soon. We start our dress rehearsal in an hour. I just need to nip back home for my dress.
Thanks for everything.
Don't mention it.
Seems my cabaret dreams are about to come true. So, around to celebrate? I'm buying.
Thanks, but I'm not really in the mood.
Have it your way. I, on the other hand, will drink. The foreman mentioned he saw you and Priscilla talking.
He's all right.
And she say anything about me?
She said something that made me think she's not entirely normal.
What?
That you're responsible, got your feet planted firmly on the ground.
You're pulling my leg.
Not this time. One thing's eating me. How do you manage to get the loan from Sophronia?
Ugh, wasn't easy. She got so excited about our performance, I had to read to her for 4 hours. 4 hours from the cloak and the dagger.
You mean you didn't?
Are you crazy? Who do you think I am?
Is that a trick question?
She's late, of course. She knew how important this night was to me.
Of course she did. Probably just making herself gorgeous. Takes time, you know.
So it's true. A woman's vanity knows no bounds.
Master Dandelion! Priscilla, she's...
What? Speak, man!
She's badly, been attacked. They took her to Vormerius Hospital.
Attacked? She's hurt? Geralt, come with me, please.
Of course, let's go.
Gods. Priscilla. Is she gonna live?
Well, I'd say that's certain. Her condition's critical but stable. Beg your pardon, but you are a relative?
Relative? No, a friend. A very close friend.
Dandelion, correct? She uttered the name in her few moments of lucidity. I am Joachim von Gratz, head of surgery. Until recently, a lecturer at Oxenfurt Academy.
Enough of the courtesies. What are her injuries, besides her eye?
A concussion, cranial swelling, incision into her larynx, and scalding inside the throat and esophagus. Clearly someone forced her to imbibe a caustic fluid.
So this was no ordinary attack, no robbery.
Clearly not. It was the act of a demented mind, and not its first.
How can you know that?
I've seen wounds like this. They're not the kind one would forget, don't you agree? In fact, just this week a corpse turned up in the morgue with similar injuries. And no heart.
No heart? You mean that might have happened to Priscilla? Is someone looking into this?
This is Novigrad. Only the innocent burn here.
Geralt, I know I owe you 100 times over, but I need to ask you another favor. Find the bastard who did this. Find him. And kill him.
Don't need any convincing. Come on, Dandelion. Let's think about what we can do. I
would suggest examining the previous victim's corpse. It has yet to be autopsied. Doing so could very well provide some clues. No need to look astonished, gentlemen. As a surgeon, I know the importance of preventive medicine. Rather than wait for this maniac to strike again, I'd prefer to excise him. Not unlike a tumor.
Think they'll let me into the morgue?
By the main entrance, certainly not. But you can also get inside through the sewers.
The sewers? Travel them often, Doctor?
As often as required for, the pursuit of preventive medicine.
Alternative treatments. Aggressive ones, I'm guessing. Interesting.
We can discuss this en route. Are you ready?
No. Need to tend to something first.
In that case, we shall meet by the Kingfisher. I'll await you there.
I'll get whoever did this, Dandelion. Even if it's Hierarch Hemelfart himself.
Thanks.
Yeah, I totally forgot about this until she said she was gonna go get her dress, and then I was like, oh yeah. I totally forgot this was a thing until that moment. But I'm gonna call it now before we dive into this next quest line, which will certainly take quite a while. So...